Hello students, this is Lipu Dani, Assistant Professor at LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. In the last lecture, we have discussed case number 3, when x is x raised to m, okay? In this lecture, we will discuss case number 4, when x is e raised to ax into v, where v is a function of x. So how to find out pi in this case? The formula of pi is 1 over function of dx, here x is e raised to ax into v. So in this case, what we have to do, we have to replace d by d plus a. So it will become function of d plus a. And then after, we have to write down e raised to ax before this vector. So it will become e raised to ax into 1 over function of d plus a into v. Then after, we have to apply 1 over function of d plus a operator on function v, okay, as discussed in case number 2 and 3, okay. So let's start with the examples. Example number 1, we have to solve this differential equation, that is d square plus 2d plus 1 into y equals to a raised to minus x upon x square, okay. So again, this is of the form function of dy equals to x. So its solution will be y equals to cf plus pi, where cf is complementary function and pi is particular integral. Complementary function is given by equating function of d to 0, and that will be the auxiliary equation. Your function of d is d square plus 2d plus 1 equals to 0. Now, you just remember the formula of a square plus 2ab plus b square. So it will become a plus b the whole square. Here a is d and b is 1. So it will become d plus 1 the whole square equals to 0. So we have two repeated factors d plus 1. So equating that to 0, we have d equals to minus 1 and d equals to minus 1. Here we are getting repeated values of d, that is minus 1, minus 1. So in this case, cf will be e raised to minus 1x, then after x e raised to minus 1x, and then after we have to write down its linear combination. So that will be c1 e raised to minus 1x plus c2 into x e raised to minus 1x, and then after taking e raised to minus 1x common, so we have cf equals to c1 plus c2x into e raised to minus 1x. Now we have to find out pi, and the formula for pi is 1 over function of d into x. Here function of d is d square plus 2d plus 1. So we have 1 over d square plus 2d plus 1, and x is e raised to minus x over x square. Now we can see that this is case number 4, because it is e raised to minus 1x into v, and v is 1 over x square, that is function of x. So what we have to do, first of all, we will write down d square plus 2d plus 1 as d plus 1 the whole square, and e raised to minus 1x by x square will be as it is, okay. Now we have to apply case number 4. So according to case number 4, we have to replace this d by d plus a. Here the value of a is minus 1, so we will replace d by d minus 1. This plus 1 will be as it is, and this square will be as it is. And then after, we have to write down e raised to minus 1x before this operator, and multiplied by 1 over x square. Okay. Now, this e raised to minus 1x will be as it is. Minus 1 plus 1 will cancel out. So it will become 1 over d square. And writing 1 over x square as x raised to minus 2. Now, 1 upon d square means double integration of x raised to minus 2. So we will integrate one time x raised to minus 2. And integration of x raised to and dx answer is x raised to n plus 1 over n plus 1. So integration of x raised to minus 2 will be x raised to minus 1 over minus 1. So it will become minus e raised to minus x 1 over d, and x raised to minus 1, that is nothing but 1 over x. Now we have to integrate 1 over x, okay, with respect to x. So integration of 1 upon x, that is log x, and this minus e raised to minus x will be as it is. So this is the required PI, that is minus e raised to minus 1 x into log x. And the general solution is given by y equals to cf plus pi, and cf is c1 plus c2 into x into e raised to minus x, okay, that is this one, and plus pi is minus e raised to minus x log x. So this is the required general solution of the given differential equation, that is d square plus 2d plus 1y equals to e raised to minus x over x square. Okay, now we will see example number 2, that is we have to solve this differential equation, that is d square minus 2d minus 1y equals to e raised to 1x cos 1x. Okay, so again this is of the form function of dy equals to x. So its solution will be y equals to cf plus pi, where cf is complementary function and pi is particular integral. So first of all, we will find out cf. To find out cf, we have to equate function of d to 0. So it will give us auxiliary equation. So d square minus 2d minus 1 equals to 0. Now we cannot factorize this equation because we don't have two numbers such that their product is 1 and their subtraction is 2. So we will apply the formula of quadratic equation, that is minus b plus minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Here the value of a is 1, b is minus 2, and c is minus 1. So minus b, value of b is minus 2, plus minus square root of b square, minus 2 square is 4. Then after minus 4, AC, value of A is 1 and C is minus 1. So it will become minus 1 divided by 2A, and value of A is 1. And so 2, 1, 2. So minus minus plus, this 2. Then after plus minus, minus minus plus, 4, 1, 4. 4 plus 4 is 8. So it will become square root of 8 divided by 2. Now square root of 8, that is nothing but 2 root 2. Now taking 2 common. So 2 in the numerator and in the denominator will cancel out, so we have 1 plus minus root 2. So we have two distinct real values. Okay, so cf will be c1 e raised to 1 plus root 2x plus c2 e raised to 1 minus root 2x. So this is the required complementary function. Now we will find out pi. And the formula of pi is 1 over function of dx. So 1 over function of d. Function of d is d square minus 2d minus 1. Okay. Then after x is e raised to x cos 6. Then now applying case number 4, we have to replace d by d plus 1. Here the value of a is 1. So replacing d by d plus 1, so it will become d plus 1 the whole square minus 2 times replacing d by d plus 1, then after minus 1 sign, and writing e raised to 1x before this vector, that is e raised to 1x, and cos x will be as it is. Now we have to simplify the denominator, applying the formula of a plus b the whole square over here. E raised to 1x will be as it is, so 1 over, it will become d square plus 2d plus 1. Then after multiplying d plus 1 by minus 2, so it will become minus 2d minus 2, and minus 1 will be as it is. Okay, now e raised to 1x will be as it is, this is 1 over d square plus 2d and minus 2d. Okay, will cancel out this plus 2d and minus 2d. Okay, then after this one is plus 1 and this one is minus 1. So again, plus 1 and minus 1 will cancel out. So it will become 1 over d square minus 2. And this one cos x will be as it is. Now, this is of the form 1 over function of d cosine of ax plus b, right? Okay, so this is case number 2. So whenever you have been given cosine of ax plus b, so what you have to do, you have to just replace d square by minus a square. Here, the value of a is 1. So 1 square is 1, and writing minus sign before it, so it will become minus 1. So the value of d square, that will become minus 1. Okay. So value of d square is minus 1. So what we have to do now in this function of d, we have to replace d square by minus 1. So this one, e raised to 1x, will be as it is, replacing d square by minus 1. So minus 1, minus 2. The result is minus 3. And this one is cos x, and cos x will be as it is. Okay. So the final pi will be writing minus sign in the numerator. So we have minus e raised to x into cos x divided by 3. So this is the required pi. Okay. So what will be the general solution? As all of you know, general solution is y equals to cf plus pi. Hence, we have to write down general solution. The general solution is y equals to cf plus pi. So cf is, okay, this one, c1 e raised to 1 plus root 2x plus c2 e raised to 1 minus root 2x. Okay, so this is required cf. So writing cf over here, that is this one. Okay, then after plus pi, and pi is this one. Okay, that is minus e raised to x cos x by 3. So y equals to this one is the required general solution of the differential equation, that is this one, d square minus 2d minus 1y equals to e raised to x cos x. Okay, right. So today we have discussed case number 4. In the next lecture, we will discuss case number 5. Okay. Thank you for watching this video.